Hello friends, you're with a Lonesome Gamer, and I'm playing Andean Abyss. And this is now the third round. Until now, not too much happened. I play the FARC, the Marxist rebels, and I managed to bring a big part of my troops into the game. The cartels are doing pretty well. They already have 8 bases, and if they have more than 10, they can win that game. So I think my next goal will be to destroy a few bases of the cartels. But now the next card is the chess player. And it's now the turn of the cartels first. So they're gonna play the event because they're first here. And let's see what that is. Less violent than Medellin's Pablo Escobar, Cali Cartel co-founders Gilberto, the chess player, cartel strategic planner, and Miguel, El Señor, cartel boss, Rodriguez Orejuela, only became a government priority after Escobar's death in late 1993 and a drug financing scandal reached the presidency of Ernesto Samper in 1994. A Colombian US strategy of combining leads and focusing resources on capturing cartel leaders netted the Rodriguez brothers arrests by 1996 and extradition to the US by 2005. Okay. And now if the cartels play that, it says Cali's Gilberto Rodriguez Orejuela expands empire. Cartels place an available base in each of 2 cities and free bribe in 1 space. Okay. So let's see. For these cards, we sometimes have special rules or some explanations on these non-player charts. So let's see. In this case, because it's the cartel is the first one here. A chess player. Yeah, down here it says if cartels non-player use bribe priorities. So in 3 spaces with both cartels and government and FARC, then AUC paces. Okay. Okay, that's for the bribe. And in each of 2 cities. So I simply guess we will determine the cities randomly first and then do the bribe following the bribe priority. Okay, so again we roll our dice, and that is this time a 2 and a 1. So this is this one here, and then it's a 4. And if you follow this here, so it's Ibagué. That's our first city. So we're gonna place a base in there. It's here. And by the way, there are never more than 2 places allowed in a space, in a city or in a department. So here you can see that, because in these departments there are only spaces for 2 bases, but also in cities you cannot have more than 2 bases. Okay, and the second base will then be in, well, that is 5 and 4. So that is basically down here. And then it is again a 5, so that would be Vaupés. But that's not a city. So now we follow these arrows here, so we start here again, and then go simply down and down, and then the next city is Neiva. It's this one here. So So that's where we place our next base. Okay. Fine. And now you can see cartels are actually now really strong and dangerous. They already have 10 bases. We cannot let that happen. So, and then they do a bribe action. So let's see what exactly that means. Here we go. Procedure, each space, cartel resources -3 to remove up to 2 cubes. Remove or flip up to 2 guerrillas or remove a base. Transfer any shipment removed if desired. Okay, so we got these here in the flowchart. We now have the bribe priorities. So in 3 spaces with both cartels and government. So we start with cartels and government. And, well, we have these 3 spaces here. And one of these spaces, we're going to do that. First, we're going to remove base, then police, then troops, finally guerrillas. So in all of these 3 spaces, we have a police. So we now randomly determine which one it will be. Let's say we start with, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so it's in Kali, we will remove the police and it goes back here to the available troops. Okay, well actually we can remove up to 2 cubes for each bribe action. So we can also move a second one, which is a troop. Okay, nice. So that was the cartels action, and now it's the AUC. And they're gonna do a operation. So let's see what the AUC flowchart says. They still have 6 guerrillas available, so they're gonna rally again. And the first thing they will do is place bases where there are at least 2 AUC guerrillas without shipments. And this is the case up here in this Antioquia Bolivar department. And to place a base, you simply remove 2 guerrillas. In this case, we remove an activated guerrilla and an underground guerrilla, because you will usually remove the activated guerrillas first. If you have the choice. And then you can place a base instead. So now that's what we do. So now there are 2 bases of the AUC in this department. Okay, that was the first rally action. And they can do this in up to 3 spaces, rallying. Then they would flip guerrillas to underground in all spaces with active AUC guerrillas, an AUC base and a cube. This is not the case. And then place guerrillas at all FARC bases, then at AUC bases, then randomly. Okay, and this has to be in non-opposition spaces. So again, we can do this here in Huila Tolima, because there is a FARC base, so we simply place one here. And finally, we gotta do it randomly, because there is an AUC base, but we already have had a rally action here, so we cannot have a second one. So we do it randomly now, and this is, that's a 6, a 1, and a 5. So that is 6, 1, 5. So this is guaviare. So it's this one, but that's not possible because there is opposition. So we gotta go on now. The next one would be meta vest, which is also not possible because of the opposition. So now we come to neva, and that is actually allowed. It's a city, so we're gonna place Agria here in that city. Okay, so that was the operation of the AUC, and they have to pay 3 for that because they rallied in 3 spaces. And then they're gonna do their special activity, which is extort. Everywhere AUC forces outnumber all enemies and include at least 1 underground guerrilla. Okay, so this time we can't do it here because it has to be an underground guerrilla. This one is active, but we can do it here. So that's 1. And that's basically it. There is no other space where they outnumber all enemies, so that gives them 1 resource back. Okay, and that was then the turn of the AUC. Okay, so now we're gonna again move these, and we come to the next turn. So that card goes now here. That one is flipped over. And again now, let's see. Yeah, the government will now do this action here, and it's a government capability. And these are actually pretty strong long-term advantages for the government. So that's something they definitely want to do. It's called Tapias. Military forces commander Fernando Tapias Stahelin drew the political backing to forge a whole of government coin effort. Okay. So it says, CO tightens civil military bonds. A sword costs 1 resource per space. Usually you have to pay 3 resources per space, but from now on, for the rest of the game, it only costs 1 resource. And we're gonna take that marker as a reminder and then place it here in the government capabilities box. Okay, and that was the government's turn. So that's placed here, and now it's me, and I can now do an event. I can now do an operation, and I definitely have to start to destroy some of the bases of the cartels. Well, honestly, I'm not absolutely sure. I could either. I can do an attack on these bases. And the way that works is that in the department where you want to do an attack, you have to activate all your guerrillas, then roll a die, and if you roll equal or less than the number of your guerrillas, then the target is destroyed. The problem with this is that you cannot remove bases before you have removed the guerrillas of that faction from this specific space. And with a per successful attack, you can remove two pieces. So I was wondering if I should wait and do another rally action and maybe place more of my guerrillas in the departments, which would increase, of course, my my chance to do a successful attack. But if I do this, there's a pretty high chance that in the next turn the bases will be protected by cartels, guerrillas. So it's going to be then even harder to do that. So I guess I won't give them the time to protect their bases. Instead, I'm hoping for a little bit of luck, and I'm going to try to do some attack right now. So basically, we got these four spaces here: Meta West, Meta East, Guaviare, and Putumayo Caqueta, where we that we share with the cartels. So I'm gonna do an attack in each of them, and in one of them I'm actually gonna do my special activity, which is an ambush. And if I do an ambush, instead of a standard attack, what I can do is I can only activate one underground guerrilla, and the attack is an automatic success. So that's definitely cool. And I'm gonna do that in an area where I have only two guerrillas. Here I have three, so there the chance is a little more likely anyway. So let's see. Let's see where I will do that. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do it here. There I'm gonna do the ambush. So that is then an automatic success, and I'm gonna eliminate one guerrilla and one base. Okay. Then I'm gonna try a standard attack here. And I got two, so if I roll a one or a two, I'm successful. Let's hope for the best here. Ah, oh, damn it. No, so nothing happens. Oh, and by the way, I can place a successful ambush, actually places a new guerrilla in that space. That was a failure here, but I have to pay for it anyway. Then in Guaviare, I'm also gonna activate my guerrilla and then gonna do an attack on a one or two. I'm successful. Yes! Awesome. Very good. That's great. And then here in Meta East, I also have to activate all my guerrillas, and here I can roll 1, 2, or 3 to be successful. So let's hope for the best here. Oh, fuck. Yeah, no, not this time. Okay, anyway, I mean, I destroyed two bases. That's pretty much what I could expect, I guess. So, at least something. I gotta pay 4 for that, I guess. Yeah, okay. So I'm now at 8 resources. And that's it. My special action was the ambush, so I cannot do anything else during this turn. Okay, so now it's the next turn. And, National Defense and Security Council. That's pretty bad that the government has to miss this, because it would have been another government capability which would make things easier. It's interesting, these cards, they kind of simulate the fact that the government improved its knowledge about how to do counterinsurgency during time. So they were more and more effective. And this is kind of simulated with these government capabilities. Okay. So, we now have this card, and in this case, because only the AUC and the cartels are eligible, the AUC will start the turn, and it's this one here, the military police rivalry. But what historically happened was Uribe's democratic security and defense policy integrated coin planning, adding a National Defense and Society Council to ensure coordinated and unified action by all state bodies. But this is not what happens in this game. Instead, we have that rivalry, which means a sweep operation activates guerrillas via troops or police, not both. Okay. So that is a restriction for the government, and if we come to sweep operations, you will see what that means. And this is now this, let me see, it's this one here. And these markers, they come with two sides. If it would have been positive, it would have been this one, but now it's this one, police or troops sweep. Okay. So that was the AUC's action, and now we come to the cartels. So let's see what they do. You got that flow chart here. Are there 10 or more cartels pieces of value available? That is the case. So we will also see a rally action in three departments or cities. Place bases where there are at least two cartels guerrillas without shipments. Well, that is nowhere the case. Guerrillas to underground in all spaces with active cartels guerrillas are cartel space and a cube. That's also nowhere necessary. Wherever cartels have a base but no guerrillas, place guerrillas, or if no guerrillas available, yeah, okay. So this is the case. And because there are actually five spaces where we can do this, where we have a base but no guerrillas, we have to determine that randomly again. Well, actually there are six. There is also Panama up here. So we simply roll a die, and we can do this three times. Okay, so that is Panama first. And because it has a population of zero, but two bases, we can place two guerrillas in there. And then, so that was the first action. Then we have five left. Come on, let's roll that again. Okay, that's the last one. So this is now Putumayo Coqueta. So we can place two guerrillas in here, because it's the number of population plus the number of bases. That's 2. And the final one, there are only 4 left now. So in this case, it's Meta East. Well, actually, that's not true. Yeah, no, it is, it is. Yeah, it's perfect. It's Meta West because, yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the order I said it. I did it for myself. So, okay, we have here also 2 troops now in Meta West, and they will protect now the base here, and they gotta pay $3 for that. 2, 3. So they only have 2 left. That's not very much. So, and after doing the rally, they can then cultivate maximal of 1. In a space with population greater 0 and where cartels, guerrillas outnumber police, place a base in a department that cartels just selected for rally. Okay, well, actually, let me see where that is. We had that one. This is here, Putumayo, Caqueta. There, they outnumber the police because there is no police. So they can place a base here. Yeah, okay. That's it. That was the cultivation action then. And that was the turn for the cartels. So that is the end of that turn now. Okay, the next thing we see here is the general offensive. The conflict during the late 1990s and early 2000s saw a number of FARC offensives, including the use of homemade armored vehicles. The government's 2003 to 2004 Plan Patriota included a major military offensive around the capital and into FARC-held territory in the southeast. Okay. So, it says, in each space possible, choose and execute either free sweep without movement or assault, if government, or free attack or terror, if insurgent. Okay, so I'm the one who can do that. And, wow. I'm not sure, actually. I could try to... I could do it. I could try to attack again the guerrillas, the cartel. But I'm not sure that makes so much sense, actually. Could also rally. Maybe that's the better option. Because all I could do now is I could only remove these 2 guerrillas. And I could not destroy a base. Damn it. So maybe... yeah, I guess I'm gonna do a rally action here. Okay, so let's see. First I'm going to rally here and place a base there. I do this by removing two of my guerrillas. And then I can place a base here. Okay, then I'm gonna do the same here in Arauca, Casanare. Also gonna place a base there. And by the way, because I now placed two bases, that brings me up here. We got now additional opposition and bases. And remember, if I got more than 26, I can fulfill, or more than 25, I can fulfill my victory conditions. So that brings me a bit closer here. Okay, so and then I think we want to concentrate here on these areas. I could also rally here, maybe that's also a good idea. Nariño, Cacao, and it's hard to say. I mean, I can actually, yeah, I think I will do that. I will also place a base here, my last one. So that gives me an additional point now. Okay, here we are. And so, okay. And then I can rally. Overall, I got $8. So I already paid three. I had to pay three for these two rally, for these three rally actions. So let's see. Then I'm gonna place one here. And I'm gonna place two here in Meta West. Okay. Here we are. And finally, I'm gonna place two more here in Meta East. Okay, and actually I think I also place one in, or two in Guaviare. Okay. I might also, yeah, I think I will. I will place another one here in Cesar Guajira, simply because I can then in the next in the special activations step, I can simply extort there, so I won't lose any money if I do that here. Okay, so now let's see how many we have. I hope I can afford that. It's one. Let me see. One, two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, I just can't afford that. Brings me down to zero. Just got 8 resources. So now I definitely have to extort as much as I can. So it's one here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let me see. I can't do it here because I don't have more than the others. 6. Okay. Yeah, and a 7. Let's do it here. So okay, I'm now at 7 resources. Okay, so and then it's the government's turn. So I didn't do the event, I did the special operation. And then it's the government's turn, and they can now, they will do now the event. So they can do a free sweep without movement or assault, if government, in each possible space. Okay, so let's see what sweep exactly means. Basically it says, for each cube in a space or department, and in a space, so in a city or department, you can activate a guerrilla. I think that's what happens here. And you can move. Usually you can also move your cubes into an adjacent space, and then you can activate the guerrillas, but movement is not allowed here. So it says, move any troops onto adjacent guerrilla free LOCs, then into adjacent selected spaces. Activate one guerrilla for each cube there. Forest, activate one for every two cubes. Okay. So that means basically we can activate one here in Kali, because we got two cubes here. We can activate this guy here. And here we got three cubes, so they will activate these here. And I think that's it. So it's not exactly a very efficient and useful action. But okay. But wait a second, I'm not absolutely sure it says police or troops sweep, because of this special thing here, of this national defense, of this military police rivalry. So let me see. Okay, I think what that means is that there is a restriction. So let me see. Yeah, I think if you do an operation, and let's say there would be in here another cube, let's say a police, then you could not activate three, but you had to decide if the police or the troops would do it. But I think what is allowed is that if you do a special activity sweep and you do it twice, you can once do it with troops and once with the police. You cannot combine them in the same space. That's how I understand that restriction here. Okay, so that was the general offensive. And then, so that's a little bit the problem, because a problem of the government, they still don't have any troops or police brought in the game. They didn't do any train action which would allow them to do that. So their operations right now are not really efficient. Okay, so what happens next? Got the next card that will show up is this one, and this is the current card. Okay, so the AUC goes first, and they're going to do this event. Let's place their marker here. Okay, so this is Senado e Camara. The left charged that not only the military but the entire Colombian political system defended elite interests by protecting right-wing paramilitary violence, and therefore constituted no more than a death squad democracy. Some claimed that a third to a half of Colombian legislators were pro-AUC. Paramilitary intimidation of politicians may have played a role. Other AUC sympathies in the legislature may have represented popular views in light of polls seeing the paramilitaries as less of a threat than the FARC. As for the cartels, buying politicians rather than terrorizing the public was a key Cali tactic, and some drug lords themselves competed electorally at the local level. Finally, legislated and political candidates who saw themselves as government FARC interlocutors engaged personally in the peace process. In any event, by Uribe's term, public distaste for the status quo provided a unified political front for his war on all illegal armed groups. Okay, so in this case it says insurgent sympathies, if the insurgent faction plays that. And it says no sweep or assault against executing faction until next propaganda. So this is an insurgent momentum card. So that card stays in play until the next propaganda. So we play that here. And that is another restriction for the government. And to remember that, we got this here, Senado, and it says no sweep assault versus AUC. So we're going to place that here as a reminder. So, and then it's the cartels, and they can then do their operation. And they are going to rally because they have more than 10 pieces available. So first they're going to place bases where there are at least two cartels guerrillas without shipments. So that's here. They're going to place two bases here, one base here. They're going to remove two of their guerrillas and then place a base here. What is that? Why is the base lying here? I think I didn't really remove that when I did the attack. Yeah, I think it should be off the board. I think it's fine like that now. And okay, we can do this three times. Let me see if there is another option here to place a base. No. As I already said, we have two guerrillas here or there. But there are only two bases allowed in each space. Then it says guerrillas to underground in all spaces with active cartels guerrillas, a cartel space and a cube. So we have that here in Cali. We have a cube there, our troops, we have a cartel space and we have an active guerrilla. So what we're going to do is we're going to flip these so they are hidden again. That was the second rally action, and then the third one, wherever cartels have a base but no guerrillas, place guerrillas. Okay, so we could do that here, Neivar on Meta East, Ibague. And also here, but we can't rally a second time in a space. So let's see, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so in this case it's Ibague, and because we can place now three guerrillas here, because it's the population plus the number of bases, so that means we can place three in Ibague. Okay. That's a little small for all the drug people. Okay. And then, after we did that, we can cultivate again. Space with population greater zero and where cartels outnumber police. So the first thing, place a base in a department that cartels just selected for rally. Okay, we could either do that here, but that's not possible because there are already two bases. And our guerrillas don't outnumber police. So we can do this here or there. In both, it is possible. So let's see. Okay, in this case, that's a 3. So we place a second base here now in Ibague Pereira. That's not good at all. Okay, and it's pretty well protected. So that city is now really a stronghold of the cartels. Okay, and now they already have 10 bases. That's definitely not a good thing. But actually, I made a mistake here. Yeah, I made a mistake here. Because I was only allowed to rally twice because the cartels only have 2 resources left. So they cannot rally all 3 times. So let me see, what was... Yeah, okay, I guess they should not have rallied... Damn, okay, where did... It's hard to say. So actually, they should not have rallied here. Because that was the last time they did it. First they placed a base, then they flipped this one here to protect their base. And the last rally action was here in Ibague to protect that base. But this is not possible. And so we can't... We also cannot place a base here with a cultivated action because we did not rally there. So we will instead place a base here in Kali with our cultivation action. Okay. So that's it. And now the cartels have no more money, which is good for the other players. And... So they have to pass now from time to time, because every time you pass, you get one resource, but they will still be pretty limited in their actions in the future for the next turns. That's a very good thing. They are really strong right now with 10 bases. Okay, so this is now the end of that turn. And now we come to this one here. It says Salcedo. So again, it would be the cartels first, but they are not eligible right now. And then it's the government. And this is interesting because there is this special symbol here, it says second ops. So in a solitaire game, usually if the second player in the turn is a if a player which is not the first one here in the turn order would be able to execute the event, if it is a non-player, he would not do it if this symbol is here, but instead he would do the ops. Simply because this thing only brings a clear advantage for the cartels. So let's say it would be now the AUC, then they would not do this event, but instead do an operations. This is what this symbol indicates. But now the flowchart that I printed out here for the government, that I still could not use, says government ignores second ops symbol. So that means, because there again, the first one here, they will now do this event, Salcedo. So it says, Jorge Salcedo was a key member of the Cali cartel's intelligence and security team. The talented, charismatic son of a Colombian general, he had military training, counterinsurgency, field experience, excellent computer skills, and fluent English. Turned informant by U.S. enforcement authorities, Salcedo opened a window on Cali cartel operations and enabled the capture of its leaders. So that's great. That's great now, because that allows us to really hit the cartels hard. So it says here, cartels informant, all cartels guerrillas to active, free assault against cartels in each space. So that's definitely cool. So now we can flip these, and here, and well, actually this is it, but still, I don't know, it's here in Panama. But it's still not a bad thing. And now we can do an assault, and that says here, in each space remove one active guerrilla or base for each troops cube. Base is last. Okay. So that means before you can remove guerrillas, you have to activate them. So usually, if this would be an underground guerrilla, we could not do an assault here at all. We could not remove anything at all, because we could not remove the bases, because there is still a guerrilla there, and we could not remove this one because it is still underground. But now that it is activated, we can actually do this. So we can now remove this guerrilla, and we can remove one base. Okay, well, that's at least a start. And then we can do the same here. There's the police, that's also a cube, and we can do this in each space. So we can remove one cube, one base here. And finally, we can do this in here. So we can also remove a base here. And then, now, when it's the FARC turn, the FARC's turn, we can do this too. So this is pretty cool now. Or we can actually do an attack. We cannot kill all the bases, but we can do a good attack, I guess. Okay, so that was the government, and now it's the FARC. So the government did the event, and then it's the FARC. And what we're going to do now is we're going to attack. We're going to attack these bases of the cartels, because we really want to hit them hard. And if we manage now to destroy some of their bases, they are out of the game for a while, because they don't have much resources left. And so that would be pretty good. Let me see. So if we do an attack now, let me see. two enemy pieces spaces last. Okay, and we can do an ambush. So, yeah, I guess what I do is, in here, I'm going to do an ambush, because that's an automatic success, which is awesome, because that destroys both bases. So I do it here. So they go back. Okay, that was my first action. And then I'm going to do an attack here. Gonna activate this one, and I'm gonna do an attack here. Gonna activate this one. So I got three more actions, one here and another one here. Okay. So let's see here. We need to roll a four or less. Yeah, okay, that's a success, and we can remove these two pieces. Sadly, we cannot remove that one, but it's not bad anyway. And by the way, for the ambush, I would gain a free goodie in here. And then we can do an attack here. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in here. So the only thing we cannot roll is a 6 here. Oh, fuck. Sorry. Of course it's a 6. Damn it. So, yeah, but still, I mean, we are really doing good. That was really cool. The cartels took a bad hit. They went down from 10 bases to 5 bases. So they are very badly weakened now. That was cool. That was a very good card. Okay. By the way, we have to flip that card here. So that was definitely good. Yeah, so for now, a fast victory of the cartels was is no longer possible. That's for sure. Okay, so let's place these, and we come to the next turn. So the next card is now Limpieza. I'm gonna flap this one here. The first ones now is the AC. So let's see what they can do. Okay, so it's this card here, Limpieza. Limpieza social, social cleansing. Killings rose in Colombia in the late 1990s and early 2000s as both leftist guerrillas and rightist paramilitaries sought to consolidate control by eliminating people considered misfits or suspected of collaboration with the other side. Paramilitaries would defend areas from guerrillas preemptively by drawing up lists of potential leftist sympathizers and then exterminating them, or using random terror to seed fear and show what might happen to anyone leaning toward the FARC or ELN. Okay, that's not very kind. And we got this one here now, Ruthless Elimination. An insurgent faction executes free terror with any guerrilla, removes any two enemy pieces in the space, and set it to passive support or opposition, unless zero population. The terror places two markers. Okay. So, let's see, I think we have a special rule here for that. Yeah, here it says Limpieza, executing faction, conducts terror in a random department or city with enemy FARC not in opposition. Yeah, if it's a FARC, then not in opposition. Remove government, then FARC, then AUC, cartels. AUC sets to support, others to opposition. Okay, so it is the AUC. First, let's roll. We can do this in executes free terror with any guerrilla. I think we do this in one random department. So let's see where that is. one random department or city. So that's a 4, a 3, and a 5. So it is Meta East. That is here. That's not good. So still, I think there has to be a Egeria there. You cannot do it in just any random department. I'm pretty sure there has to be a guerrilla there of the executing faction. So we can't do it in Meta East. The next one would be Vihara, which is not possible because there is nobody there at all. Then it's Guyana, and it's now this Amazonas area here, which is also not possible. The next one would be then Putumayo, and that is actually possible. This is here, and there is now this guy here. Okay, so yeah, with any guerrilla, exactly. So now we gotta activate this guy here, because that's a terror action, and I can show you what a terror action does here. Any spaces with underground guerrillas, one resource per city or depth selected. This is not the case here because they can do that for free because of that card. Activate one underground guerrilla in each selected space. 8 minus 3 if one space, or minus 5 if two or more spaces. So the 8 goes down here. 1, 2, 3. If the AUC does terror, then the 8 goes down. If the cartels or the FARC does the terror, it does not happen. If department or city plays terror and shift support or opposition one level toward neutral. Okay. So it's a little different now. Sets it to passive support or opposition, unless zero population. Okay, so what happens is now, this thing is now set to passive support, because it is the ASC, and it is set here, ASC sets to support. So we're going to take that one, place it here at passive support, and that means now that I lose the 2 points that I gained here from this. So that goes down, this opposition, and the government gains 1 point because there is now passive support there. Okay. And in addition, we will have to place 2 terror markers here. Usually you only place 1 terror marker per terror action, but this time, because it's extremely cruel and brutal, we gotta place 2 here. And that's an interesting thing, because if we want to change the opinion here, for example the support or the opposition, then we have to pay for that, to do this. And we have to pay more if there are more terror markers in there. Okay, so and we can remove any 2 enemy pieces in the space. So we will remove these 2. And in this case, we will remove the undercover or the underground ones, because that's a little more harmful for me. Okay, so that wasn't exactly a great card for me. And then it's the cartels, and they will do now, well, usually they would do their action, but they can't do it because they don't have any money. So if a non-player faction doesn't have any money, they simply pass. So they go down here, and they gain one resource, which is not a lot, but at least something. So that means now in the next turn, they are also eligible. And that means now these two go here, that one goes here, and now it might be also possible that we get a new and it will be actually the case that we are not, that we don't share our turn now with the government anymore, but we will now share the turn with the cartels, which could change the game a little bit. Okay, so that was the end of that turn, and yeah, I guess I'm gonna load this up now, and hope things are starting to get a little less confusing. And I see the problem now that the government is not doing many operations. That could have been a factor of the fact that I played always together with the government. I had my turn always together with the government, and I did not use the events. I only did use my operations, so there were always the events left for the government. And so they still didn't have, they still don't have any troops on the board. But on the other hand, that must not be so bad, because right now the game is actually still pretty balanced. You know, no one is really close to a victory. The cartels were, but they were really, really hit hard by this traitor. And so right now, everybody is doing, well, not too well, actually. No one is exactly close to the victory conditions. Okay, so hope to see you in my next video. Until then, bye.